Hi, I'm Nitin Sukhija, and you are watching IndiaPostLive.com, India's first live conversation portal. Ladies and gentlemen, you can join the conversation here by logging on to IndiaPostLive.com or tweeting us at IndiaPostLive or hashtag IndiaPostLive. IPL is back with a bang. It's back in India. But will it boost the ratings? Take a look.
The prayers of IPL fans have been answered. The league is back in India and will open with five-time finalist Chennai Super Kings taking on defending champions Kolkata Knight Riders this evening in skipper Dhoni's hometown Ranchi. Indian players such as Suresh Raina, Ravindra Jadeja and Ravichandran Ashwin of CSK are expected to perform better now that they are back home. Looks like there's no stopping them from giving a tough fight to Kolkata Knight Riders. While the ever-consistent duo Sunil Narayan and Piyush Chawla has kept their game up, Captain Gambhir and his aide Yusuf Pathan have been the biggest worry of the collapsing batting order. So will being back in India get IPL the expected eyeballs and the Indian players back in form?
In conversation with me on IPL today, I've got two senior sports journalists with me in studio. Chandrasekhar Luthra and Rahul Banerjee. Is it going to make a difference, IPL back in India?
Well, definitely, because these wickets mostly, you know, suit some of our star players, and especially some of the players, because in UAE what has happened in Middle East is that bowlers have actually dominated the last leg of the, I mean, rather, I would say most of the, you know, half there. And this was very, I mean, unpredictable for some reason, because IPL or T20 is mostly about batsmen, and it's the batsmen who are suffering in UAE.
Sure, because Punjab team won't agree with you.
I mean, again, Punjab is only one team, and that is also because of the foreigners, not because of Indian players.
Yeah.
And because this league, we expected more Indians to perform, because in this T20 is more about Indian players. We talk more about Indian players, and this is a seventh season, only the foreigners are performing, be it Maxwell, Miller, or for that Sunil Narayan, everybody, you know, McCullum or Dan Smith, they all are performing, whereas Indians have taken a back seat, apart from some of the bowlers. Of course, bowlers for likes of Sandeep Sharma, I think he has impressed everybody. And everybody is now talking about why he has not been given chance into Indian team. He's swinging, he's bowling alongside, you know, Mitchell Johnson. And he has impressed everybody with his speed, with his swing, with his, you know, the trajectory
in Abu Dhabi.
So, in a way, I think, apart from bowlers, our batsmen have somewhere taken a back seat, and now we expect all this Suresh Raina or Gautam Gambhir
Gautam Gambhir has to do something after three ducks.
So, in a way, I think things will change. And apart from Chennai or Punjab, who has done well there, all other teams are somewhere at the number with the 4 points, and only one team with zero. So in a way, there is a lot of competition.
So they all wanted to come back to India.
Obviously, they will have to, you know, perform well, because in the next they have already played 5 games, everybody, and now in the next 5, it will be a do or die for everybody, and especially for a team like Delhi or for a team like Mumbai, who has not even won a match. You know, for them, it is next 5 games they'll have to win in order to be there.
To be in the competition. Yes. Well, he talks about the performances, talks about batsmen wanting to perform and finally coming down to Indian pitches. But television and the audience, I mean, you know, this time the television ratings have taken a dip. IPL has largely been a television event. It's not been it's not a cricketing event where you actually go and watch cricket techniques, right, and performances. So do you think the television ratings will improve?
I'll just add to a little couple of points to what Shekhar mentioned. One of the reasons why the Indians particularly have not done well, batsmen, is because, for one, the grounds are larger.
Okay.
And they are not used to playing, you know.
2020.
They are used to playing, you know, a little 55 and a half yards, 60-yard boundary. So, you know, that's why you have six.
But wasn't that a deliberate attempt in the beginning to make the boundary shorter, to make
that's
it more exciting?
That's what I'm saying. Over there, they refuse to compromise.
Yeah.
There, they have set boundaries of 70 yards and odd. Okay, now here you have
regular cricketing boundary.
55 and 60 yards. You miss it, the ball will still go for. Now you will see Suresh Raina suddenly becoming a tiger. Because if he does this, the ball will go for a 6. Okay, so as far as they are concerned, our heroes are concerned, now they will go back to being heroes.
Yeah.
Because now you are back to bhaiya jo lagaya to chala gaya, that kind of a thing. So going back to your other point about television, I think in any case, what we have seen over the last six seasons is that IPL is more a location-driven event of spot.
On the ground,
you know,
yeah.
Grounds will be full. Like Delhi will have, you know, 35,000 people. Mumbai will have, it's Wankhede will be full. Largely, that's the pattern we've seen, and I'm sure that's going to happen again. Outside of that, the television and the web world, from what we are hearing, have largely remained indifferent or not as excited about this as they have been in the previous years.
Yeah, they've not been.
Yeah, and I've got a very interesting mail from one of these web companies yesterday. They run, you know, research on the kind of traffic the various websites around this draw, and they have reported a very, I won't say drastic, but a fairly steep fall in terms of, you know, whether it's live streaming, even live streaming of matches has not attracted the sort of attention it used to in earlier years.
Earlier seasons. Yeah, we have Tala Masood joining us. Tala is a cricket expert and a sports journalist. Hello, Tala. Hi, Nitin here.
Hi, Nitin. How are you?
I'm good. Yeah, thanks. Tala, we were talking about, when we lost you in the connection, we were talking about IPL being back and it boosting the ratings. So, Mr. Luthra talked about the performances. He said, suddenly, you know, we talked about, suddenly Suresh Raina will turn into a tiger, Rahul said that. And because the grounds are smaller, grounds are your own pitches. But also, we were talking about TV ratings, yeah. Because people are not interested. Will it affect? Because when it comes to India, will the crowds be coming to stadium more? Will the people be watching, be interested more in television performances?
Yes, certainly. I think it will go up for a bit because when the tournament comes back to India, people would go to the ground. So the interest is obviously there. So there is going to be an increase, but it all remains to be seen, you know, because I still think the elections are the biggest news in India right now. So maybe till the 16th of May, you won't find that kind of an excitement even on social media. But after that, I think the tournament will pick up when it comes to people supporting it, people going to the grounds and even watching on television.
And what's your take on performances? You think Raina will turn into Tiger now?
Raina is a very good T20 player, I think
or anybody else for that matter. I mean, yeah.
Sorry.
I'm saying, will Gambhir start scoring now?
Well, let's just hope he gets a run first, and then let's see if he starts scoring or not.
Well, he got 45 the other day, so you know he has actually started getting runs.
Yes, 45. Yeah,
Before that, 0-0-0-1, and then 45. Yeah. So he has
so
a total of 46
nine,
runs.
Average is 9.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So maybe now 45 goes in and he turns it around into 54, then you know and takes it on from there.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I think it is more because you know when we talk about Gambhir or Sehwag not performing, I think it is more of a pressure. They have added more pressure onto themselves because they are actually very desperate to get back into the Indian team, and that is through only IPL because they have not done well in the domestic. Gambhir, of course, it was a mixed bag, but Sehwag was a complete flop. And then you know after domestic there is nothing to prove before the England series, so they have taken this platform in order to you know perform and knock at the selectors' door, which has completely backfired because this kind of cricket you actually cannot predict whether you can be in form or you can be out of form. It could happen to anybody. So it has actually added more pressure onto themselves. And now with coming back to India again, I think it will be again if Gambhir is playing in Kolkata or in Delhi, both are.
They're playing in Ranchi today.
In Ranchi. And then,
now Ranchi is also a very interesting point.
Very interesting.
You know, is Ranchi a home ground for KKR or is Ranchi a home ground for CSK?
Exactly.
It's a home ground for Dhoni anyway.
Exactly. It is definitely a home ground for Dhoni. But for who else?
So this time is Chennai is home ground.
I think Chennai is home ground. Yes.
So will it affect the morale? I mean, for Calcutta team, for that matter, you know, Kolkata Knight Riders. It was till last season. It was my home ground.
Yeah.
Okay. It was branded as my home ground, so I had that home advantage. I don't know how that works.
I think the way they have shuffled this whole tournament around it, that home and away thing has become a joke.
Yeah.
If Rajasthan, who had such a wonderful stadium and a wonderful support, were not given their own ground and were thrown instead to Motera in Ahmedabad. So this whole concept of home and away
from Chennai, you come down to
exactly. So you know, that's, for this year at least, it's become a bit of a joke and a bit of a nonsense. So I really will make no difference to the teams. Like Shekhar said, coming back to home conditions where the ball will come below your knees and you're back to getting onto your front foot and lagging your bat, that will happen very quickly. Because up till now, when the ball was flying past the nose, you know, the fast bowlers are actually looking a lot better than they are.
Yeah.
I mean, Sandeep Sharma, let's face fact, he's a good bowler. He's a very honest player. And he has a lot of pluses, but he really doesn't have the kind of pace to worry, you know, top-class international batsmen. So, their control and all came into play because you had green tops, you know, green pitches where the ball was bouncing.
And the weather is also a factor.
And weather also, because there was no watching in between, because since this tournament started. So ball actually started flying after half of the tournament there, you know. And later on also, spinners also came into play. Though again, you know, spinners have actually not impressed.
Actually, how many IPLs have you seen spin dominate? Exactly. Other than Sunil Narayan. Yeah. But here, Match after match. Because the other reason, again, going back to my point of being bigger grounds, our guys used to hit the ball over the top. Yeah. Where in India, you will get a six. You get caught.
Tala, I've got a tweet. Vikas Huda says, IPL 7, man hi nahi hai dekhne ka. Overdose of cricket. Because that's a viewer's honest confession. Say this overdose of cricket, mera man hi nahi. I don't feel like watching this thing. But tell me, if you were from Ranchi, If you were a guy from Ranchi and you know you were supporting the home team last season, which was the Kolkata Knight Riders, so are you going to support the home team which was there last season, or is the home team CSK this year?
If I'm from Ranchi, I will just support one man called Mahendra Singh Dhoni.
Whichever team he plays for.
Yeah, because that's how the city functions right now. I mean, I was in Ranchi a few days back and I saw an auto which said MSD on it. So, you know, you can just, that's the kind of support he's generated in that city.
Yeah, he's the Rajinikanth of cricket, yeah.
Well, yes, you can say, but he does not like throw guns which split into five bullets. He just does what people can think that he can do.
Yeah,
actually.
But do you think it will suddenly start attracting attention more? Because there's one tweet with this guy saying, you know, it's overdose, money nahi hai dekhne ka. He doesn't feel like watching.
No, I think one thing that is definitely going to happen is the runs will start flowing. As Shekhar sir and the other gentleman was talking about, immediately when we come back to India, the runs will start flowing because the grounds are smaller. They are into the, most of these guys have played domestic crickets across the ground in the country. So the runs will start flowing from the Indian bats as well. I mean, if that happens or not is still conjecture, but from what we see and know, that the runs will come. So the interest gets generated because, let's face it, we are a country which is dominated by people who love to see bat and basically bat.
Yeah. And you know, just to, you know, add a couple of things more.
Yeah.
Why your man will be, you know, there, because you don't feel like watching these matches because actually you don't belong to any team. You actually cannot ask yourself whether to support team A, team B, because most of these players, the idea of catchment area, you know, which initially was started on the basis of like Real Madrid or Manchester United having their homegrown, you know, youngsters and becoming a superstar after a while. Messi is a fine example for that matter. But what has happened in last 6 years? The catchment area has completely failed.
Yeah.
Your players, which you picked, they were either picked on some biases or because of some politicians, or as I was saying, Lalu Prasad Yadav's son played for Delhi Daredevils only to sit in the dug-up and then taking the, you know, some money and then little bit of clout. But overall, Unmukh Chand, what has happened to him? He has not got a game so far.
World Cup.
That Tiwari. Manoj Tiwari and then another Saurav Tiwari. He was a big star, you know, initial year, first 2 years. Now what has happened to him? He's not playing for any Kolkata Knight Riders. He's somewhere in some other team, maybe Mumbai Indians. He has not got anything. Then Parvez Rasool, he should be there in the Punjab 11, but he's somewhere, you know, Sunrisers. He hasn't got any match. For that matter, I think if you have to
there's no sense of belongingness.
If you have to actually create an interest among the masses, there has to be some homegrown players. For Delhi, it should be like Virendra Sehwag, you know, with Unmukh Chand, with couple of other homegrown players. But this has
interesting point you've raised. Does it, Rahul, affect also in the team? I mean, fine, as a player, as a viewer, I don't have a loyalty towards a team because the players keep changing, right? But amongst the players, their teammates keep changing.
I mean, look at just the fact that the four younger Indian captains, how badly they've done. Yeah. Rohit, Shikhar, you know, all
Gambhir.
Four of them.
Gambhir.
Yeah. So, you know, none of them have really been because of the same point. And you're used to playing in the Ranji Trophy or an under 19, under 21. You have a homogeneous setup. Now, all of a sudden, you have this star cast, international players, plus players from other states. So, you know, getting them going in the same direction, I'm sure, is pretty much... Though they're all professional cricketers, they have the same idea. I'm sure everybody gets to the field, they want to win. But getting them going as a captain is definitely is not easy, because here, like I said, you're a Delhi boy, you're mixed with your Delhi teammates, you all think the same way, culturally you're very similar, you will operate in the same way.
Right. You'll have share your chola bhatura.
Yeah, exactly. You know, if you're from Chennai, you'll go out and have a, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Let's not typecast, but you know.
No, but that's what it is. Yeah,
it happens.
It is, yeah.
Now, all of a sudden, you have, you know, Brendan McCullum, who's going to be talking about having a beef burger and beer, to somebody who for whom vada pav is the most important thing in life. You know, how do you, culturally, how do you even match these two guys, you know?
Talab, you're talking about Delhi and Delhi chola bhaturas. So, I mean, coming back to Delhi pitch for that matter, has the Delhi pitch been better? Because last game again, Lanka was stopped. If you remember, after 25 overs, because some of the players were hurt and uneven bounce on the pitch. So, has the Delhi pitch been better?
Delhi pitch is a very funny story. You know, something or the other keeps on happening on the Delhi pitch. But it just remains to see how it plays out when the IPL comes back. And the games are played there. The ground has come up. I mean, which I'm sure Mr. Shekhar will agree that the infrastructure around it has improved. But the pitch is something that sometimes acts up. I don't know what are the reasons for it. Why does it happen? And in some places. But just to add on to what we were talking about, you know, the cultural differences. I mean, I personally believe the IPL wants to, the BCCI wants to run the IPL how the football leagues are run in Europe. And that's not possible because cricket is a very different sport. That is my personal opinion, because in football, you have an entire home team, you have a young team, and then they graduate into the other team. So that doesn't happen in cricket. So I think that is also a reason why, you know, how much can you support individual persons and just have a fan base based on stars? I think that has to falter at some point.
You know, cricket is a very interesting. 2007, we were both, me and Rahul were there in Australia with Indian team, and the tradition or the way this Melbourne wicket is being laid is basically they get the artificial turf, then they set it up, and then they play cricket on this. 2 months before a match, they get a artificial wicket out of the somewhere from New Zealand or some part of Australia. So, I mean, we were also talking about why this can't happen in India. So, for a instance, I was just trying to look at the financial thing, that how much you have to spend. I was told somewhere between 25 to maybe 40, 50 lakhs, that could be a total cost of laying this kind of wicket. And interestingly, Delhi for that, you know, for this particular reason, I think Delhi is the costliest wicket in India, not in India, but in the world. They have spent only once I was told that more than 50 lakhs have been spent in one season to relay the wicket a couple of years back. And after that, there were so many, you know, times, Kotla wicket, so many times they have relaid, put mitti or some kind of. So, I mean, this is the costliest wicket and this is the worst kind of patch, you know, as far as the cricket is concerned. But still, because there are so many cooks, there are so many experts. If you give this wicket to one groundman, you know, one old groundman, I know Ali or some other guys there, they can prepare a better wicket. But because there is a tussle between the associations, people, former players, you know, curators, this wicket has not been made the way it should have been.
But do you have any interesting story?
This is the costly wicket. Let me tell you, if they are under RTI, if somebody, I wish they will come under RTI, somebody should put a RTI and ask, maybe few crores have been spent on this wicket in last 6 or 7 years, but this wicket is the same, or rather it has become worse in last 6, 7, 8 years.
I mean, before this season started, Shekhar will agree, The kind of tussle we saw between Gautam Gambhir, who's leading the Delhi team.
And Venkat Sundaram.
And Venkat Sundaram, who's the chairman of the pitches committee of the BCCI. They were literally almost came to fisticuffs.
Achha, this clout, this is an interesting point. That, you know, back in India, now that you're back from Abu Dhabi, so all the captains and every home ground's advantage or not advantage, they will have their clout in preparing the pitches the way they want to and all.
Of course. Yeah. To some extent, yes. But then, like Shekhar said, you know, if you're going to go into the DDCS...
My home ground is way back, way...
That is one. Secondly, if you're going to get involved in DDCS politics where the home captain has no say, Gautam Gambhir as captain of the Delhi Ranji team has no say in what the pitch is going to be like, then it makes no difference.
But Gambhir seriously needs to perform now.
He will. I mean, like everybody. I said, all of these guys are going to perform everybody. Now. Everybody. They're all going to perform.
Piyush Chawla has been doing well.
Surprisingly.
Yeah, because is it because the spinners are doing well in Abu Dhabi, or is it because he's...
I think he has grown in stature, in weight, in everything.
No, I think so, what also, just watching Amit Mishra bowl, oh, yes, has told Piyush Chawla a few things. Piyush has always had a problem. He does not... He gets too defensive very quickly. He doesn't like getting hit. Now, we saw with Amit Mishra the night, the previous day. Right. He got hit for 27 runs in one over and his team still won.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, he's not afraid to take a battering. With Piyush, the problem is the moment he comes under pressure, he starts to, that slightly negative sort of bowling. So, hopefully, watching Amit bowl and then Chahal and then Tambe bowling.
Oh, yes. Tambe
traditional leg spin. Traditional leg spin. The real strength of leg spin, with the way, the loop the ball. Don't give the batsman speed. Let them hit you. It could be done there. Unfortunately, I'm not sure whether we will see that in India anymore. Because again, going back to my original point, small ground. Miss hit, six runs.
Yeah.
Everybody tiger, poor bowler.
Yeah. Tala, who's your pick? Piyush Chawla, the guy who's big in stature, literally, or Amit Mishra, or Harbhajan Singh?
No, Amit Mishra, hands down. He's been exceptional. I think he looks very complete bowl. I mean, he looks a complete leg spinner. From what I can make out of it. So I think Amit Mishra, definitely. Harbhajan Singh, Mr. Rahul was saying, he's now started bowling very defensively. And it hurts. As a fan who's watched him for so long, it hurts that he's bowling so defensively.
So do you think that the point that we've been discussing, that since the grounds are going to be smaller here, the spinners are not going to be doing so well?
Absolutely. There is no two ways about it. The ground, forget the grounds are smaller. These are no conditions to maybe 70%, 75% of the batsmen who are batting. They are going to be hitting it by crazy. So like what Mr. Rahul said, small grounds, batsman tiger, bowler poor.
Yeah, but since you move into India, the batsmen were tiger in Abu Dhabi also. Is that the batsmen were not non-Indians? Foreign batsmen were tiger there also.
No, but that's the whole point. I mean, if you play T20 cricket in Melbourne and if you play T20 cricket in a ground like Ranchi, it's very different.
Yeah.
Because the size of the ground, the conditions of the ground. So that is probably that added to the advantage of these guys like Glenn Maxwell, Brendan McCullum, because they're used to playing in condition where the boil is slightly rising and still being able to hit it.
So you think Maxwell and Miller magic will continue in India as well?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they're
song. I think we are going to see a very dramatic shift.
Yes.
In the way the run getting is going to now start.
No, that,
you know, these
true.
Overseas batsmen. Sorry, Tala, I didn't want to interrupt you.
No,
please carry on, please.
No, sorry, sir. You can complete your point.
Tala, you complete your point.
You go ahead first.
Yeah.
Okay, no, what I was just basically saying is that because Miller and Maxwell have had 5-6 knocks and they've done brilliantly, so that just adds on to the form. But having said that, I mean, you cannot rule out from the fact that, once a good knock, say, for example, from a Raina or from any of the Indian guys, they can get going at the rate of knots.
Just what I was going to say is now, always, over the years, overseas batsmen, with very few exceptions, don't go well in India. The bounce is so low. They're not used to this low bounce. That's what I'm saying. You will see now a paradigm shift in the scoring pattern. It's our batsmen. The Indian batsmen will now start scoring runs. These guys who've been getting, big runs so far, because the pitches have, the ball has been coming on evenly, you've got to guarantee, the bounce is going to be this much. They will now struggle because pitches in India are so two-paced.
But they've been playing in India for last 6 seasons.
Doesn't make a difference.
But there is a difference between Maxwell, Miller, or for that matter, Maculum or Ross Taylor or AB de Villiers.
Yeah.
You have to understand that Maxwell and Miller, who have actually outperformed everybody, are not technically so great, or they were not so established. So probably, they were not getting that kind of concentration when it comes to, dressing room, kind of tactics, So they were actually given a free run by most of the team strategists, and that's how they scored initially. But once the focus will shift to their batting, once they will be marked, once they will be, their technical problems will be, somewhere looked at, probably they'll find it difficult, because most of our spinners will actually try and, fassau them in their, web. Whereas now the Maculums or Ross Taylor, for that matter, who have played so much and who are technically much, much superior than them, probably they can still continue to do you know, better than these guys. But it will again be.
It's already started. Maxwell's run in the first three games, and then look at his run in the last two games.
Yeah.
Dramatic fall. Similar with Miller. Now, I will not be surprised. Even now, CSK has got a very good partnership going with Dwayne Smith and Brendan McCullum, who have done actually really well. And I will not be surprised if they now change that partnership, because Indian conditions are going to be so different.
So the batting orders will change in every team.
Probably definitely.
Because let's not forget, at the same time, Brendan McCullum has probably the very first match in IPL when he got 153
for Royal Challengers.
Blistering, no, for Calcutta against
for Bangalore.
Bangalore.
Blistering North, fabulous. So he will probably continue. I think they will now, all teams will start reassessing the batting order, and we'll see a lot of him. But Rohit Sharma probably will now come to open for Mumbai.
You know, most of these you know, foreigners for that matter, they like when the ball comes onto the bat.
Yeah.
They can go backwards and then also hit a punch. When it actually comes to, you know, just playing the forward shots only, then somewhere because of the bounce, they are not used to getting too much down. That's very important for a batsman. So technically, if you are somewhere, you know, you have been sorted out, then it could be a very difficult task for you. But again, it will all comes down to now spinners rather than the pacers on Indian conditions who could take care of these batsmen.
Yeah, I've got two more tweets now. I've got Ankit saying, Ranchi is the home, their own lion, MS Dhoni, and he's put the city on world cricket map. Yes, Ranchi. Ranchi has been put on the world cricket map.
They're going to have test cricket there very soon, let me tell you that. He's there, he's the boss of Indian cricket at the moment. And with
all the scandal going on, he'll still be the boss.
He's not affected by it so far.
Yeah.
And he's got international cricket, he's got a brand new stadium built in that town. Yeah. I'm from Ranchi, by the way.
Right.
And I know that town.
And
what he has done to Ranchi is
fabulous.
He's actually brought it
on the
somebody
map.
Said put it on the world map. Absolutely.
So I've got another tweet saying Surendran Nambiar is saying it's all about how one performs that day. That's why it's a tamasha. So IPL as a tamasha, what's your take on it?
No, IPL is a tamasha, but not because how that person performs on that day, because that will encapsulate cricket as well. It's a tamasha because it's a soap opera that goes on for a month and a half.
Yeah.
It is the original idea behind starting a IPL in 2007, if you remember. It was not to show any cricketing kind of skills to the viewers, but it was basically...
It was television.
It was basically to replace all those Saas Bahu series. Because what Mr. Lalit Modi was targeting is slot between, you know, 7 to
prime
10.
Time, yeah.
When, you know, Ekta Kapoor serials were on the one side and he wanted to replace it with the...
So it's made for television event.
It is basically a 70% tamasha, 20% of cricket and 10% of your, you know, day-to-day activities where you actually somebody will come up and
kind of... You forgot the glamour part of it.
Yeah, that's where...
And the money part of it.
Shahrukh one side, PT on the other side.
Cheerleaders every side.
Cheerleaders everywhere. So, yeah, it's very important.
And 100% money.
And 100% money. Definitely. Everybody is trying to be a, you know, rather not play for their countries, rather hide their injuries, postpone their operations in order to make this kind of money. So, Virendra Sehwag, we have seen one big decision when he took by preponing his shoulder injury, he paid dearly for that. So, most of these players, be it, you know, Gilchrist for first six seasons, you know, retiring from there and then making money here. You know, this has actually become a rather, you know, lucrative league, somebody for the retired people and not for the youngsters. The catchment area has flopped, your youngsters are not performing. There is very less that the cricketers, the budding cricketers are getting, be it the money or the glamour. It is mostly those retired or established who are getting more money. It's like established, you know, factories which are making more profit rather than the
new. Also, let's be fair, it is given... say a Praveen Tambe a platform.
Oh yes.
Outside of Navi Mumbai or Mumbai, who knew him before?
One or two players are actually coming.
So it does give.
It does give. Yeah.
You know,
for that matter, Yusuf Pathan was a product of this.
Correct.
Then Unmukh Chand for some time. Then, you know, couple of players. Yes, every year you are getting focus. At least one or two guys are coming into
also,
focus.
But also, Shekhar, I have a youngster like Sanju Samson, 19-year-old, playing alongside so many great players. This boy is one for the future. He may be a product of the IPL. He is a product of the IPL. But he's also you know, playing alongside Rahul Dravid, now playing with Shane Watson, playing with so many big
names. So there is, yeah.
This is, these are small investments.
Yeah.
Like, I agree. There are two or three players only.
No, but that's what the intent was.
But this is a spin-off. Players like Sanju Samson, Vijay Jol, or for that matter, if Unmukh Chandy, you also consider him the India material, they should be playing regularly, because the way Sanju Samson that day played, you know, alongside
that is the beauty of the Rajasthan Royals.
That's the temperament he has showed.
No, also is the team.
I'll just go to Tala for the last comment. Tala, before we wrap up, what's your pick? Chennai or Punjab? As a winner, not today's game.
I think it's going to be a close one, but I'd slightly say that Chennai might outside Punjab. But it's still a very long way to go. We'll still need to see what's going to happen in the tournament. It's a very long tournament. But just last comments on what we were discussing about players coming in from the IPL. I think, yes, Sanju Samson, Unmukh Chand, all these guys are very good. But I think my maths professor in class 10 told me, you can have the best teachers around, but it's on the student to learn. And I think that is somewhere which the youngsters have missed out in this entire format.
Okay, it's time to wrap up. Ladies and gentlemen, the conversation can continue here for long, but we need to wrap up this time. Please keep joining us on indiapostlive.com and keep tweeting us. Thanks for watching.